I don't think I considered getting anyone else to teach me because I feel like it's a thing where if it's not broken, then don't fix it.
Didn't know it's your responsibility as a driver to make sure all the doors are closed.
Yeah.
Yeah? So if I fall out the car, it's your problem, yeah?
You're teaching me, you know. You need to make sure the door's closed.
No. I'm teaching you what I know. So in the future,
right.
You make sure your passengers are safe, okay?
All right.
Okay. In England, it's a survival. If you can drive, you'll survive. If you can't drive, it's harder to survive.
Say my love.
Okay. Hi, brother.
How is it? All of us ended up learning with Lloyd.
It started with Tashan. Once Tashan passed, he passed on to you, you to Brandon, and then Brandon to me. It's kind of like I was just following the tradition.
How do you feel passing now?
I feel accomplished, bro. Nowadays, it's the guys with cars getting all the girls, you know what I mean? Somebody with a license now, I can join that club, you get me?
Not having a license, it kind of limits me a bit because I'm a bit spontaneous, so there might be times where I want to just go and link the mandem or just a sense of having that independence and being able to do things your way, you know?
I think once you start driving, you can't go back in it. The bus line looks different.
The first thing I want to do when I get my license, I feel like I'll just go on a late night drive, play music loud.
Learning to drive is a great independence of people. The first time I've ever sat in a driver's seat at about 12:30, I feel that's one of the best days of my life, like that feeling. Just a freedom to just have that machine in front of your hand, and it feels good.
I was born in Manchester, Jamaica. I grew up on a farm, so life in Jamaica was positive before. But regardless of whether it's positive or not, if you get opportunity to go somewhere, you want to go.
When people travel a lot, that's the best education they could ever have.
I'd say you just expand your mind.
When people don't travel and stay one place, they're stagnant. You need to travel to gain more knowledge, and knowledge is key.
I wouldn't say I'm quiet, but, you know, I keep to myself. I'm not really outspoken or extroverted. I've recently learnt the importance of networking and getting yourself out there because, you know, it's the people that you know that can help you.
I push the steering then just to help you guide you out of it. So we're going to come.
You don't trust me.
Huh?
You don't trust me.
You trust the bank. Come on, give me some gas.
Obviously, apart from my dad and my older brothers, there's not really a person that I can pick out and say, yeah, that's my role model. Lloyd was my driving instructor, but I'd say that I would see him as a mentor as well. He's stern, but I'd say he's comedic still. But he's just an easy guy to speak to. There's not really a boundaries on what you can talk about.
The advice I give is try to give you confidence and make you believe in yourself.
Keep going, clutch to the floor now, clutch to the floor. Cover the brake to stop it nicely.
Too quick, eh?
Yeah.
I
have this concept of teaching that I actually learn from my dad. So what I learned, if a student is doing something wrong, you just be more calm and just saying, would you like me to help you again? What don't you understand? Going into someone's mind and find out what the best way to teach them and achieve that. Now, I enjoy that part. Because sometimes it's difficult for some people to learn at different levels.
I failed my first test.
How did you react when you failed?
Like a disappointed dad. He was just hanging his head low. It was a quiet drive home.
I do feel a passion for them to pass. Yes, I do feel a passion for them to pass.
You feel positive for them, for the direction they're going to take in life.
Just a fulfillment to know that someone who finds it really, really difficult to learn, and then you actually work hard to actually get them through. It gives you great joy at the end. Do you think you could move out by yourself?
Yeah.
Go on then. That's not bad, is it?
Not bad.
Yeah, man. My youth, standing up.
As I've grown older, I kind of see the need to have a license just so I can be a bit more independent now. I'd say it's definitely a sign of growing up, you know. It allows you to be responsible.
Most youngsters are thinking about driving to school, have a nice car. It's like a social thing, you know. I think more mature people are thinking food on the table, yeah. If you could drive, you have a more chance of feeding your family. And if you teach an ambulance driver or someone, they're going on to save lives. How important is that? So I think for every driving instructor, I give you that drive to realize that you're making that change in society where people can do stuff for themselves, because that person, you'll make a different impact on their life. The same person you teach today is the next person. The same person gonna be an ambulance driver tomorrow. It's gonna be a police driver the next day. It's gonna drive the fire brigade the next day. You hear me? Freedom is good. Independence is the best.